So today let's try to make an edited quick video about nickel metal hydride and nickel cadmium chargers and their oddities and their output waveforms. There is something weird about them. I have this intelligent charger and also those dumb chargers. Focus. This is unedited, so whatever I record goes to YouTube. This is an intelligent nickel metal hydride charger and some dumb chargers, and you'd say those chargers probably supply some constant current into the batteries until you either unplug it or until some microcontroller will disconnect it. And that's partially true, but is it really a constant current? I mean, like a DC constant current, or is it some high frequency or low frequency pulsed current? Of course, it's not AC, it has to be DC, it has to be a current in just one direction, but is it a continuous current or a pulsed current in some way? So I decided to connect my oscilloscope to them and measure the waveforms of the current that goes into the batteries. And of course, I could put some current sensing resistor in series with the batteries, but it's also possible to measure the voltage on the battery, because of course the battery has some internal resistance. So when I measure the voltage on the battery, especially in AC only mode on the oscilloscope, I can also see the charging current waveform. And those chargers, you'd say that they just supply a constant current and then you have to unplug it. Of course, those are dumb chargers, so it basically supplies the current forever until you basically unplug it, and you have to calculate the charging time yourself. You basically have to calculate the charging time based on the capacity of the battery and divided by the charging current. For example, those are 1000 milliamp hours and it supplies 100 milliamps. So it comes out as 10 hours, but of course the batteries are not 100% efficient, so it's not 10 hours at 100 milliamps. It's about 14, 15 or 16 hours. You have to multiply the number by about 1.5 to get the charging time, basically. 1000 divided by 100, 1000 milliamp hours divided by 100 milliamps is 10 hours if the battery was 100% efficient, but in reality it's 15 hours roughly. And you'd say it's a constant DC current, but it's actually not. And those chargers, even if you take a look at those LEDs, you see some flicker in the camera and you don't normally see it by your naked eye, but if you move your eyeballs, for example, from some point here to some point here, if you're experienced, you can kind of see the flicker, because as you move your eyeballs quickly, let me draw it, you see something like this. Here is basically the LED, and here is your eyeball, and you move it quickly from here to here, and you see the LED as not all. If it was a DC current in the LED, you would see basically a line like this. If it's a pulsed current in the LED, you see something like this. So you can see that the LED current is pulsed. And when it's 100 Hz, it's usually like this, with some zero crossings. And if it's 50 Hz, you can see something like this, basically. And so just by using your experienced eye, you can tell that the current in those indication LEDs is not a pure DC. It's a 50 Hz pulsing, basically one half cycle, and this one as well. It flickers, which may suggest that the current in those batteries is also pulsed, also probably one half cycle. And my guess is that it's those dumb chargers are something like this. The mains voltage goes through a classic transformer and one diode and some current limiting resistor, if it's not limited by the resistance of the transformer. But I think there is a resistor in series, because then it can also sense the voltage drop on this resistor. using an LED to indicate basically there is a current going through it. And some of them charge two batteries in a series, so it doesn't work for odd numbers of batteries. And if they have four batteries, then I think it's the same circuitry connected to the secondary once more, but in the other polarity. So the transformer is loaded by one circuit in one polarity and the other circuit for the two other batteries in the other polarity. That's my guess. I haven't opened it, actually. I have to open some of those chargers in some of my videos, I think. But now, instead of opening it, let's actually measure the waveform it supplies into the battery. So I botched my oscilloscope on it and you can see it's one half cycle pulsing. And this line is zero and it's 500 millivolts per division, so it's half a volt, 1 volt, 1.1 or 2 something, and those half cycles superimposed on it by the charger, and of course my light is reflecting in it. Focus. Unedited videos. Amazing, isn't it? So here's the waveform. 50 Hz and those half cycles charging the battery. And now let's try to switch it to AC only, because this is a DC mode. When I switch it to AC only, you will be able to actually zoom it a little bit and see the half cycles like this. Of course the trigger level is somewhere disappeared, and here's the 50 Hz half cycles in it. Isn't it nice? But of course it's not necessary to use a smooth DC current for those nickel cadmium or nickel metal hydride batteries. One half cycle is just fine, and maybe also it's better for the batteries if it's pulsing for some reason. Maybe for some reason it's better for the chemistry if it's charged by those pulses. And I have several of those dumb nickel metal hydride or nickel cadmium chargers, and I think all of them are using one half cycle coming from a standard transformer. I have one old here nickel cadmium charger, and it probably also contains a classic transformer, and as well as this one, which doesn't even say which type of batteries does it charge. But it was probably nickel cadmium. Yeah, it's nickel cadmium. Because back then it was basically called just a charger, because there was just nickel cadmium batteries in those standard sizes and no other batteries, of course. And this one is quite interesting. Let's take a look at it. And it's quite big and it has 5 positions and it can charge those 9-volt batteries, or actually 7.2 or 8.4, with 6 or 7 cells in series, nickel cadmium or nickel metal hydride batteries, and also 4 positions for batteries, anything from AAA probably all the way to those huge, probably D batteries or at least C. It's quite a nice charger. It can fit basically anything from AAAs all the way to those D batteries. Of course, this one is not rechargeable, but just to test if it fits. And it works nicely. And there is a tester. Not just a charger, but it also has a tester, which lights up. And I guess there is just a tungsten lamp connected to the battery to test it. It's not an LED because it's warm white, but back then probably no LEDs like this, just tungsten lamp. And it's also better to use a tungsten lamp to test it because it loads it more, so it can indicate that it's really charged and doesn't have a high internal resistance, of course. And also Of course, one battery has a too low voltage to light up an LED. Those batteries are 1.2 volts, so you couldn't even use an LED to test it. And it works even when it's not plugged. It's probably a tungsten lamp. And of course, it's also probably 1/2 cycle, and the LEDs flicker as well. And the last one, which is almost like a new old stock, it seems. And it even has the smell of new appliances when you removed them from a package back in the 90s or 80s or something. And it seems to be for batteries. And it has two LEDs, so I guess it's like a pairs in series, and it has a switch for normal or quick charging, two different charging currents, and it says 50 milliamps or 120 milliamps. And this one probably wasn't in use. It has this, the cable isn't even unwrapped. That's nice. It's probably like almost 30 years old. And so let's test it. One battery, nothing. It's probably series pairs, of course, and another battery, and the LED comes on. Can I change the... And when I move the switch, well, the normal makes it a bit dimmer, and quick makes it a bit brighter. And again, a flickering LED, so it's just 1/2 cycle from a transformer going to the batteries. And the other side of it, does it work? Yes. Very nice. A nice German charger. Here it's in German and in English. And also the charging current is here and charging times. It says charging times, but it doesn't say what kind of capacity of the battery should it be. Given that you usually multiply the charging time, the theoretical one, by 1.5, it would be about, let's say, 15 hours. 50 milliamps, that's how many? 750 milliamps goes into the battery, which means 500 milliamps goes out of the battery. Well, 500 milliamp battery, probably nickel cadmium, that's quite a low capacity. So it was for even older batteries than my 1000 milliamp hour nickel cadmium. But anyway, this video is getting horribly long. It was meant to be about 8 minutes or so. So let's go to this intelligent charger, which is definitely the weirdest one out of those chargers. Now let's try to measure the waveform that goes into the battery, which is quite surprising to me. And here's the waveform, which is quite weird. It's like a very rough square wave. And those pulses, which are about 25% duty cycle, pulsing into the battery. But the weirdest part is how slow this pulsing is. Let's take a look at the time base. It's 1/2 second per division, which means that it's like 1/2 second pulse and 1.5 seconds gap. So it's all repeating every 2 seconds. 1/2 second current going into the battery and 1.5 seconds nothing. That's really quite weird. It really is a super slow pulsing. When I make it even slower, well, it's like the medical devices showing the heartbeat or something now. And you can see the pulses in real time now. This is how slow it actually pulses the current into the battery. And the duty cycle of it is about 25% or 1/4, which suggests that, and I actually confirmed it, it actually goes through the four positions for the batteries one after another. So it's basically a charger for four batteries, but it actually charges just one battery at a time. It basically has just one constant current power supply, and it actually switches it 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And it says for triple A's it's how many? I don't want to move it because it will fall off, the cables would fall off, but I think it's 120 milliamps for triple A's and 260 or 360 milliamps for double A's. So I guess if it's the average current, then the peak current has to be four times this, which means almost half an amp for triple A's and how many? 1.34 amps peak current for double A's, which is quite a lot. It literally goes through the batteries 1, 2, 3, 4, and no matter how many batteries you put in it, each of them has 25% of the time. Even if it's just one battery, it basically goes through all the positions. And I guess maybe when it's not supplying the current into the battery, it's measuring the voltage on it. I don't know, it's possible. It's quite surprising, actually. Or actually, it's not as surprising that it goes through the batteries one after another, because otherwise, if it was charging all batteries all batteries simultaneously, it would basically need four individual constant current regulators, which would make it quite complicated. So it actually makes sense to go through the batteries one after another. But what's surprising for me is that it's such a slow switching. I would actually expect it to be switching at, I don't know, couple tens of hertz or couple 100 hertz, maybe 50 hertz, 100 hertz. But it's actually going through the batteries at half a hertz repetition rate, which is quite slow. And maybe it's done like this because in the meantime, it measures the voltage of the batteries, which is quite possible, which is actually more accurate than measuring it when it supplies a current into it, because it has basically more voltage when you supply a current into it, because you drop a voltage on its internal resistance, and also the resistances of the contacts would basically skew the measurement significantly. Of course, those resistances of the contacts are quite random, so it's not easy to actually somehow subtract them in the microcontroller. So it probably makes more sense to measure the voltage when it's not being charged. So that's the waveform, and it's quite rough on top, but I guess it's just some aliasing. Basically, it's some high frequency ripple, but this oscilloscope now samples at quite a low rate, so it's aliasing. Basically, the samples are fitting into random places of the high frequency ripple. And of course, I'm just making a video about those cheap supermarket batteries and measuring their capacity, and I noticed those oddities of those chargers, so I decided to also make another video about those weird waveforms from them. And of course, I'm just measuring the capacity of one of those triple A's. And of course, the other video is going to be a proper edited video. And of course, I had to cut a little bit of this plastic wrap on the battery to even make a contact in this charger, because some batteries have this plastic wrap going over the edge, and in some devices the contacts are such a way that it doesn't make a contact. And the charger makes a strange sound. You can somehow hear the switching, or actually the power supply makes strange audible noises when it's not loaded. Can you hear it? It's like three quarters of the time you can hear it. So that's it.